EZVIZ, you probably know them for their security cameras, but they do make other products like robot vacuum cleaners and this right here, which is a portable power station. It's called the PS1300. Its maximum output is 2000 watts and it has a 1324 watt hour capacity. Now it can charge up to 80% in just 1 hour. It has a built-in battery monitoring system that I'll be testing out later on to see its overload protection. And it does use LFP battery cells, which is what you want in a battery station such as this. So they're good for, well, up to about 10 years plus. And after 3,000 cycles, they drop down their capacity to about 80%, which is excellent. So you're going to get a lot of use out of a portable battery station such as this. So I'll be testing out its solar charging. It can charge actually up to 1,300 watts, but my panel right here is 400 watts, and we'll see what kind of rates I can get. I'll do a few little tests on it, and I'll let you know what you need to know more or less about the EZVIZ PS1300 portable power station. Take a look at what EZVIZ does include with our PS1300. So we have this little top compartment, and this is very handy to have all the cables with you when you carry it about. Normally they are separate with most other brands there, but maybe we do miss out on perhaps having, say, wireless charging on the top because of this compartment. We've got here our solar charging cable, and the input, the maximum that you can charge is 60 volts, 1300 watts, which is excellent. Our AC charging cable, as I pointed out in the intro there, it only takes an hour to get up to 80%. And here is our car charging cable there. And finally, a quick start guide and QR code. So for inputs here, that is where your solar charger here, DC input or the car charger. So this ranges from 13 to 60 volts. There is a reset button right here. And this is our AC input, 230 volts here with this European version I've got. And we've got a power on and off for each of these sections here. This is the main power that is for our AC out, and this is for the DC side of things here. So we've got power delivery type C up to 100 watts, and then we've got these three USB type A ports. Now the type A's, they output 5 volts, 2.4 amps maximum with those. With our AC side, two plugs, so this is a maximum of 2,000 watts, and that is not each of them, but between them. So you can have 1,000 watts on one, 1,000 on the other. As long as you don't exceed the 2,000 watts, it won't then trip out its safety. And that is its over-voltage, overload protection, temperature protection, over-current protection, short-circuit protection, low-temperature protection, and low voltage protection. That's all in there, part of the battery management system that we typically see with other power stations, such as this model. It is actively cooled. There is one fan here you can see, another on the other side. So that's going to be giving us that airflow going through the unit to make sure that it's not going to be overheating. And I'll give you a sample of the fan noise later on in this video. You will certainly hear it, especially when it's under demand with the high outputs and the high charging rates too as well. You can see that other fan on the left-hand side. So there are these corner bumpers made out of solid rubber to protect it. And the two handles on the top, which are very solid, and it helps you move it about because it is heavy. It's about 21 kilos. For my solar test here, I'm using a 400 watt panel. Now the maximum input it can handle is 1300 watts, which is very good for the size of portable battery station. Now the sun is out here in an optimal angle. There's no cloud cover, so I should be able to get the maximum top charge rates. Let's take a look at them now. We're looking at 361 watts at the moment, and the smart display is telling me I have 1 hour and 16 minutes until it is fully charged. It's just got 25% to go as I am currently at 75%. The screen is telling me there. So not a bad rate at all. I think the maximum I've seen out of this panel is around about 370, 380 watts. So it's doing really well. Good conversion there, charging at that 360 watts. So what is the PS1300 going to be good for? Well, any appliance, any power tool, anything that's up to 2000 watts maximum. It does have a peak of 4000 watts, but that is only for a brief few seconds. You can't rely on that. So this drill, for example, this is 600 watts. Let's test this out. Not a problem. The trimmer right here, that is all going to work. And I do have, say, for example, an electric bike here that I'm charging up. I have some other battery operated garden power tools, but I can use the PS1300 to charge up those batteries along with the solar panel. So it's all going to just be self-generated power here with the battery station. One of my favorite uses for portable battery stations is something like this. Imagine you need to vacuum your car, but you have no PowerPoint handy. And you don't want to use one of those portable vacuums because, let's just face it, they're pretty useless, aren't they? They don't have a lot of power. So I have now a vacuum here that pulls about 1,200 watts, and that will give me around about an hour's use here with the PS1300 if it is fully charged. So it's quite a bit of time to be able to vacuum and clean out at least two cars. So let's put it to the test now. What I've noticed is as soon as I turn on something that's very powerful, you hear the fan inside the PS1300 straight away come on, but as soon as you turn it off, it stops as well straight away. So let's test this out. Okay, that is going to work just fine. Again, we're only using about 1200 watts with this, so well within the 2000 watt limit. So we have AC charging, solar charging, and in emergencies, you can charge it in your car. Now, this I don't recommend because it does put a lot of load on your car's alternator, probably not worth it. But for emergency use, you can charge. Now, it's only going to be 120 watts, my charging rate here using my car. Other cars do output at 24 volts. This is a 12-volt system this car uses, but it's a good option to have, but it will take a very long time to fully charge it. As you can see with this car charging at 104 watts, it's going to take 5 hours, just over 5 hours, to charge 25%. So that's why I say just for emergencies, really, but good option to have.
Now for this test, I want to really load it up and it will be triggering, I'm sure, the overload protection. We'll see what happens. So here first, a hairdryer, very powerful, common item. See if I can put it onto the top setting. Pulling 1200 watts at the moment, but then I'll turn on the top setting now. It's pulling just over 2170 watts and it's sustaining that. So that, okay, it didn't sustain that for too long. I went over the 2000 watts and the overload protection that has tripped. There was a little beep there. And of course the AC side of things has cut out. So I do now have it plugged in and I'm charging at 1300 watts and I can see UPS is there on the display, on our smart display. So it's charging at its correct rate. It tells me I've got 38 minutes to go. This is from 72%. And what I'll do now is just turn the hairdryer on the lowest setting. So I'm pulling 1200 watts approximately. Okay, so that's pulling 700 watts now at the moment, not as high as I thought. I'm going to unplug now the AC to check out that UPS function. All right, that was very quick. You just heard it in the fan noise of the hairdryer, the changeover, but very fast and great to see that UPS is working well. So the fan is currently on, but it's a low RPM as it's charging at 1300 watts. Now what I'm going to do is load it up again. This will be the worst case scenario. You hear that fan come on. So the higher the load, the louder it does get with that fan noise. But this is going to be the loudest you will hear it.
So EZVIZ has a decent portable power station here because we have the 2000 watt output that I showed you. You can use that with various different appliances. And we have the fast charging too, can get up to 80% in just 1 hour. Very handy to have that. You've got car charging, the solar charging that I showed you. And that is one of the more powerful inputs we do see with these kind of portable battery stations, because normally it's limited to say 400 watts or 800 watts. But this, it can handle 1300 watt solar input and the charging rate, which is very good. And they are using those LFP battery cells. Always great to see those. They're very good in terms of safety and you're gonna get just so many cycles out of those because after about 3000 cycles, you're looking at a capacity drop of only 20%, which is excellent. And they'll go for over 10 years too, which is another great thing. So what don't I like about this particular unit here? Well, it is great that we have this little compartment at the top with our cables. You certainly will not misplace them. I feel like it's a little bit of missed opportunity when it comes to the space that they could have used here. They could have had a wireless charging pad on the top. They might have had a little bit more room for some more DC outputs. I feel it's a little slim on the DC output side that we should have had at least a cigarette lighter. The car accessory output port on this would have been great, and perhaps another couple of DC ports there would have been handy for people that are using, say, motorhomes, RVs or something. So it would be ideal for, I think, for people that are going to be using power tools, garden tools, like the examples I showed you, because you'll be able to get closer with this without having to run around with annoying extension leads. Or maybe you're just somewhere that doesn't have power, but you need this. So it's going to be good for that. For a bit of a home backup thing for emergencies. Another area which would have been good, that they could have had an LED light on this too. Wow, would have been very useful. I do see that with a lot of other models. And I hope when they work on some other models that they can add that to. It would be good if they do later revise this. It's the only kind of things that's missing really is that cigarette lighter and an LED on this would have been good, I think, for camping purposes. Otherwise, solid build quality to it. The handy screen information is great. You can see the remaining charging time and your current time left when you are discharging. So like a power tool, if you're using something like a vacuum with this, well, it will last typically, if it's about 1,000 watts, for around an hour, just over an hour with this. So thank you so much for watching my video here on the EZVIZ PS1300.